Hi, welcome. My name is Nikki, and this is the video where we're going to learn about how to make your design workflow 10 times faster in Figma.
Okay, so the very first one is a duplicate. So there's three ways of duplicating an item in Figma. The first one is a very standard one. You just select the thing that you want to duplicate and you hit Command C and Command V and you just drag it on the side. Next one, you select the item, Command C, and then you hit Command D, you place it on the side, and then you hit Command D again. Figma places the next item, the next duplicated item, next to the item where you put it first. Let's just do that, and let me show you how smart Figma is. So let's just do it again. So you select the item you want to duplicate, Command C, Command D, I'm moving it vertically now, and then I hit Command D again. So see, Figma understands that I would like to place this item below the other item. So that's really handy. And the last one, which is probably my favorite, I select the item and I click Option. I believe this is Alt on Windows computers. And then I drag it to the side and I hit Command D. Do that like this, like vertically, Command D, and Figma is super smart this way. The next thing is moving or nudging things on the screen. So you already know that when you click on something and then you hit the arrow key, then you can move things around. And when you hold down the shift key and you press the arrow key, you can move things with the nudge amount that you have set in preferences. And this is how you can change your nudge amount. Come to the main menu, preferences and nudge amount. By default, Figma has 10 pixel here. I have it set for 25 pixel, so you can just change it back to 10, or what I like to use is 8. And then now when I shift arrow, the text is moving with the nudge amount. If you would like to select an item and you have a lot of items on the screen, there are multiple ways to do this. The slower way is you just click until you get to the element that you would like to select. So let's try Command C, Command V. Yes, it is selected. But the faster way is you just gotta hold down Command and hover over the items that you would like to select and click. This way the item is selected, so we can try Command C, Command V again. If you would like to direct select multiple items, you can do it by holding down the Shift key while holding down the Command key as well. So I hit Command, then I click, so I selected this, and then I click Shift, and then I can select that and that. So I have three items selected. As you can see, these are underlined, Command C, Command V, and it is done. The next one is cropping an image. I show you two ways. This is the slower way. When you select the image, you come to the image panel, and then you hit Crop, and then you can just adjust this image and hit enter. Now we cropped our cute panda bear. And the faster way of cropping an image is you just select the image, hold down Command, and then you just drag these sides. Okay, now this is okay. And then you just click away. If you don't click away, you just hit enter and then the image panel comes in. You can adjust the image further. The next one is changing opacity. There are multiple ways to change opacity on an element. I will show you all three. So the first way of changing opacity is you select the item and here on this panel, you just click the percentage and when it is highlighted, you hit the arrow key. So I'm hitting the downwards arrow. This is like 50%. And then I hit enter. Next way to change opacity is you select the item, you come to this panel again, you click here, type 50%, hit enter. And it is the same color. Okay, and the last way of changing opacity is you select the item that you would like to change. If you would like to change its opacity to 50%, then you hit number 5 on the keyboard. See, these are the same opacity levels. But let's investigate this a little bit further. So if we go back to our first example, you see that our fill color changed here. On the second one, again, the fill color changed. But on the third one, we kept the fill 100%. But on the layer level, the pass-through rate changed. I think if you are the only one who's using your file, this is perfectly fine because you know what you have done. But if you're working in a larger design team, you probably would like to apply the same rules because maybe somebody comes here, they actually don't pay attention to this layer level, and then they just keep changing this fill. And with that, like, nothing changes. I cannot even increase it to anything, right? So just be mindful of that. So let's say you would like to copy this text style. So you would like the text to change to have the same styling as the headline. So what you do here is you select this and then you click Option Command C. You select the other text and you press Option Command V. And now both texts using the same text style. And the next one is, if you would like to see the distance between these elements, you need to select an item. So this is kind of like your key object that Figma measures to, and hold down the Option key and then it shows the distance in pixel. How you can tidy them, select these, and then when you hover over, this tidy up button comes up and then you click, and then now they are at the same distance. The next one is organizing things on your screen. So if you have a bunch of things just lying around and there is no organization in that, so what you can do is you select all of them that you would like to organize, and when you hover over, this little icon just appears. You click that and ta-da, they are organized, and then you can move things around. So the next one is renaming. So how you can do it, you select the items that you would like to rename and you either right click on this panel and then choose rename, or you have all of these items selected and you hit Command R, and then this dialog comes up. So you have a few options that you can adjust, and you can type in whatever you want to type in. So I will rename these buttons and then click rename, and ta-da, all of our items are named button. Okay, so let's say you would like to draw a circle. So you hit O, that's for oval, and then you just start to draw a circle. So if you would like to keep things proportionate, you need to hold down shift. So I'm holding down shift. I am keeping things proportionate. So these are in the center. So let's say I would like to resize items. So what I do is I select the items, I grab this edge and I'm dragging it. But what you can see, this is actually not circles anymore. They are ovals. So they are not really proportionate. So if I hit shift, then I can keep things proportionate again. Sometimes you might need to scale things up. So instead of selecting the frame and holding down shift, you can see that this doesn't change anything at all. You can see that we increase the space between the text. We have larger space in between the subtitle and the edge of the frame, but actually we didn't scale things at all. So let me just comment Z here. So what you do is hit K on your keyboard. So you can see that how we have this double arrow here. So and now when I try to resize this, I also scale the subtitle, the image size, all of the text size as well. The next shortcut is super useful when you know that you have an item somewhere, it's just not visible. So you don't know where you put it. And because we didn't name our items here, therefore we cannot really find it. So if you're familiar with Illustrator, then this is the outline option. So you hit Command Y. And then we can see that we have a square here, and this is what I'm looking for, the smaller square. Unfortunately, we cannot select it this way, but when we go back to a non-outline mode, then I can just remove this and move my tiny square and move this one back, and all good. Sometimes I find these sidebars a little bit too distracting when I'm working, so I like to hide them. And how you can hide them, it's very easy. You just click Command and period, and those are hidden. And all of your other shortcuts are still working. So if I would like to put a frame here, then I just hit F, the frame appears there, and I can bring the sidebars back by clicking Command period again.
These are my tips and tricks that I've been using in the last couple of years. So if you know something else, then please let me know so then I can learn something new from you too. Also, if you're looking for a Figma UI kit library, then make sure you check out this video that I created a few months ago. Maybe you find something useful there as well. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I hope I see you soon. Bye.